Oh my god, Google, what is going on? Why is the calculator from one of the biggest companies in the world acting up like this? You'd think that a company whose name is inspired by an insanely large number would know its way around the mouth, right? Well, not always. Let's talk about what's happening here. Turns out Google's calculator has some trouble handling really large numbers, which is actually a common problem in computing. But still, you'd expect Google to have this down by now, so what's the deal? Example time. You see, when you take a number with a ton of 9s and subtract a ton of 8s, you should get 1, right? Seems simple enough. But when you plug that into the Google's calculator, it sometimes says that the answer is 0. Wait, what? That's like saying 9 minus 8 is 0. Imagine trying to explain that to your math teacher. But it gets weirder. Let's take an example where we have 42 followed by 40 zeros minus 41 followed by 40 zeros. You'd expect the answer to be 2, right? Well, Google says it's 0. Okay, Google, are you feeling alright? So what on earth is going on here? Let's dive into the nerdy stuff. Big numbers in computing are often expressed in something called floating point format. It's like a math's version of a magic trick where a really large number is split into two parts. A small number, called the mantissa, multiplied by 10 raised to some power, the exponent. Think of it like scientific notation, but for computers. For example, Google's revenue in the second quarter was $1.25 billion, which can be written as either this or this. That makes it easier for computers to work with huge numbers. Cool trick, right? Except here's the problem. The computer can only keep track of so many digits. So when you do math with really huge numbers, some digits just get lost in translation. It's like trying to fit all your groceries into a tiny bag. Some stuff is just not going to make it home. Here's another thing to remember. Computers do math in binary using only zeros and ones, while we humans are over here doing math in decimal using digits from 0 to 9. So when Google calculator has to convert between the two systems, tiny mistakes sneak in, especially with huge numbers. Basically, the calculator isn't failing math, it's just rounding a lot. Like, a lot. It's trying its best to give you the right answer, but it has to cut some corners because there's only so much memory to go around. So Google calculator doesn't really fail at math, it just has to make some compromises when the numbers get too large for its tiny binary brain to handle. And no, we don't have infinite memory, so it's tough to store those giant numbers exactly.